हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ मिस रचना जैन, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट पीजी कॉलेज, राजगढ़, अलवर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द पोयम, शॉर्ट पोयम ऑफ भवभूति। हिज पोएट्री ऑलवेज वर्दी व्हेन इट इज ओल्ड। दिस पोयम इज इन द सिलेबस ऑफ बी ए पार्ट थर्ड, इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, पेपर फर्स्ट, यूनिट बी। Topics of my video lecture are introduction to the poet Bhavbhuti, his major works, his poem, his poetry always worthy when it's old, and the explanation of this poem with context. Bhavbhuti's lifetime probably was in the later half the 7th century AD. He was resident of Padampur in Vidarbha in South India. His father's name was Nilkanth and his mother's name was Latukarni. He was Brahmin by caste. He was devout worshipper of Lord Shiva. Many shlokas were composed by him in praise of Lord Shiva. It is learned from Kalhan's work Ras Tarangani that Bhavbhuti was the court poet of Raja Yashovarma of Kannauj. His active life as a poet is supposed to be from 693 to 729 AD. He had extraordinary command over Sanskrit. As for his education, we learn Bhavbhuti was educated at Padampura, the place which was 42 kilometers southwest of Gadur. He was initiated under the Guru Paramhans Dayanidhi, who became his guru. It seems at a place called Kalpi, which is situated at the banks of the river Yamuna, Bhavbhuti got his inspiration to write all his historical plays. He shot to fame for his three Sanskrit plays, which are Malati Madhav, Uttaram Charit, and Mahavir Charit. In his works, we find great scholarship and genius. His works are full of description of the beautiful scenes of nature. His major works. The major works of Bhavbhuti are Mahavir Charit, Uttaram Charit, and Malati Madhav. I give you the brief introduction of these three plays. His first play was Mahavir Charit, in which Bhavbhuti describes Ram's marriage, Ram's exile, Sita's abduction, and Ram's coronation have been detailed described. In Uttaram Charit, Ram's biography after his coronation has been described. In the play Malati Madhav, the love and marriage of Malati and Madhav have been described. The main plot is said to revolve around the love story of Malati and Madhav, while the subplot of story is about the love story of Makarand and the Mayantika. The fascinating love stories with some horror events depicted by Bhavbhuti in this play make it outstanding in Sanskrit literature. Bhavbhuti is most adept in picturization of rasas or feelings or emotions. The way he has described Ram being ruthless in banishing Sita and then Rama weeping like a child, a revelation can rarely be found in Sanskrit dramas. Similarly, it seems the vir ras or the heroism is exposed in Rama's courageous speech, Rudra ras or anger in Parshuram's speech, and vibhats or disgust in describing the demons and their corpses. In Bhavabhuti's dramas, extraordinary characterization, plot construction, exquisite language, style are found. Bhavabhuti also composed shlokas on the principles of poetry and criticism. Poem for you. If learned critics publicly deride my verse, well, let them. Not for them wrote. One day a man shall live to share my thought, for this time is endless and the world is wide. This is the short poem. It has only 4 lines. In this stanza of 4 lines, Bhavabhuti expresses his indifference to the adverse criticism of his poetry made by some learned critics. In the very first line, he says, if learned critics publicly deride, publicly means openly, before everyone. And deride means make fun of, ridicule. So Bhavabhuti says, if some learned critics consider his poetry to be of no worth and ridicule it and make fun of it publicly, then let them do. If they make fun of his poetry, let them do so, because he says, not for them I wrote. He says that he does not care at all for such adverse criticism, because he did not compose his poetry for such critics who find fault with his poetry unnecessarily without understanding the significance of it. One day a man shall live to share my thought. In the 3rd line, Bhavabhuti shows his full confidence that a day will come when a man will understand the worth of his poetry and will appreciate it. Such a man will share his thoughts embodied in his poetry. In the 4th line, he says, for time is endless and the world is wide. Bhavabhuti says, the time is endless and world is wide. The world is not coming to an end with these critics who ridicule his poetry, who do not understand the depth of his emotions in the poetry. So he is sure that in future his poetry will be appreciated, and this thought and his thoughts in his poetry will be shared by the people of the world. Thus Bhavabhuti expresses his optimism about his poetry and thoughts. This was this simple poem of 4 lines. Now, thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.